the only Boston organization that has hit more home runs than the Red Sox is the Dana-Farber Cancer Institute.
I think Dana-Farber is in the lead compared to other institutions that treat cancer because of the access to clinical trials, the cutting-edge research, and the compassionate caregivers there.
So our purpose is to help you live your financial lives through the power of every connection. So we flipped the company, so we said, it's about the customers. It's about the customers. It's about the customers.
There's a real urgency in what we do. You know, 10-year delays for new treatments just don't work. We have to come up with new treatments as soon as possible to help people today, but also to change the field tomorrow.
One of the greatest things about working at the Dana-Farber is having my colleagues across the institute, adult and pediatric, because the investment made in cancer is an investment made in precision immuno-oncology or new drug development that we benefit from in pediatrics.
Our goal is actually to start to keep our science in-house longer by funding this work in-house ourselves. So rather than sending it out early to a partner, we will speed up the time to get this work to patients, and we will also, again, create more value for Dana-Farber. So it's a little bit higher risk, but the reward will be higher as well.
It's not going to be about just trying lots of stuff because we can, but trying the right stuff and knowing how to understand the results of what we try so that we can make things better.
On the 26th of November, my company will open a new research facility here. 400 of our researchers will move to Boston. They will be working full-time on understanding cancer biology. We want to have, not daily, but twice a day, interactions with institutions like Dana-Farber, because it's only if we work together day and night that we'll be able to translate science into medicine.
We have put in place a very wonderful organization at Dana-Farber that allows us to do our jobs, collaborate the best as we can with industry, and then work with the FDA, advise them to help bring things to patients as quickly and effectively as possible.
We're engaged at Alnylam in a lot of rare diseases where the patient community and the patient input to the entirety of what we do from a drug development and even drug commercialization perspective is central.
The outcome of the RACE Act and the new FDA guidance regarding eligibility at age 12 means that our patients in the pediatric oncology clinic will begin to see clinical trials of new oncology drugs much earlier in their life cycle of development.
We don't always know what the next discovery is going to be and what are the highest priorities, because somebody has made a key discovery that we can see has huge implications for new treatments. And when we see that, we want to have the freedom to say, all right, I have this pool of unrestricted funding, and we can put it where we most need it.
Who wouldn't want to be on a visiting committee? The incredible talent of these doctors, the incredible devotion they show to the patients, and the opportunity to come here and listen to them once a year and hear about all the wonderful work they're doing. Who wouldn't want to do that? It's fantastic.